Welcome back. In this video, I want to talk about the idea of truthy and falsey. What do they mean? And you'll hear this a lot in Python programming. You see, up until now, you've used booleans here as values. So it was really easy. If true and true, then run this code. But Python can do other things as well. For example, if this was 5 and this was, let's say, hello, what do you think will happen here in our program? Well, if I click run, you are old enough to drive and you have a license. Is that what you expected? And this is because what Python does underneath the hood is actually convert these to booleans for you. So it's almost as if it is doing this. Remember type conversion. We're converting the type to boolean as soon as we get to this if statement because Python is saying, hey, I want true or false. I don't care what is old is. I don't care what is licensed is. Just give me true or false so I know whether to do this or to go to the else block. Now, if I was to just print, let's do this here. Let's do print boolean hello and then finally print boolean 5. Let's see what we get. We get true, true. And this is what we call a truthy value in Python. That is, it's a truthy value because if we run the boolean type conversion on it, it evaluates into true. What's a falsy value? Well, if I do 0 and if I do, let's say, an empty string and I click run, those are falsy. That is, it's not actually false, but it is falsy because if we run boolean on it to Python, it's going to say, oh, this is false. And 0, that's false. And that kind of makes sense, right? And if you actually go to Stack Overflow, if you've never seen Stack Overflow before, if you ever have programming questions and you're Googling them, usually the top 5 answers will contain either 1 or 2 Stack Overflow answers. And basically what happens is people ask questions like, what is truthy and falsy in Python? And you get answers. So you can see over here that it has 4 answers. And you usually look for the check mark, which means that this is a verified answer. It means that, hey, this question owner has accepted it as the best answer. So the person who asked this question just said, yep, this is the right answer. This is the best one. But you also have other people voting. So you can see that this answer received 46 marks. And although it was marked as the correct answer by the user, maybe somebody else came along later on and gave an even better answer. So now we have 123 upvotes. And you see that this answer is a lot better. All values are considered truthy except for the following. So you can actually see here that in Python, these values are considered falsy. You can see 0 here. You can see an empty string here. And then there's a few other ones. Empty set. You have an empty dictionary, empty list, empty tuple. You have decimals. You have things like fractions. You have 0.0. False is that. And also none is falsy. So that if I type in none here, that's false too. Now, you don't need to memorize these because most of the time it makes sense, right? But it helps us do conditional logic very nicely. For example, let's remove this. And let's say that we have a user. And this user has to have a password and a username. If, let's say, the username is Johnny and the password is 123, well, instead of me saying, hey, if this user has password and username, and we're not checking if the username exists or password exists, we just want to make sure, hey, did this person fill out the form and did they try to submit a username and password? I can just simply say password and username. And I don't have to worry about converting this to a boolean or anything like that because if password and username exist, then try to log them in. and you see that it reads a lot nicer. Because each one of these get evaluated into a truthy and falsy value. It's a nice little feature to keep Python, well, nice and simple and reading like English. I'll see you in the next video.